Hello students, I'm here again with another topic for literature students, and the topic is literary devices and important terms. Literary devices. There are numerous literary devices in the world specifically for literature, and today we are going to cover part one of it because this is so vast, this term is so vast that it cannot be covered in a single video. All these terminologies are important for UGC NET and all the students who are aspiring for MA English entrance exam. Here are the topics. The topics that I'm going to cover in this video are simile, metaphor, hyperbolic, personification, alliteration, metonymy, symbolism, imagery, allusion, euphemism, eulogy, foreshadowing, horizontal communication, diagonal communication, upward communication, downward communication, prima facie, carte blanche, carpe diem, and vox populi. All these terms has been a part of last year MA English entrance exam of Delhi University. Simile is a figure of speech that directly compares two things. So the first thing that we are going to discuss today is simile. It is a figure of speech that compares two different things in an interesting way. The object of a simile is to spark an interesting connection in a reader's or listener's mind. For example, as happy as a clam, as light as a feather, they fought like cats and dogs, and as cute as a kitten. Next one, metaphor. Metaphor is a figure of speech that directly refers to one thing by mentioning another. It is a speech in which a word or a phrase is applied to an object or action to which it is not literally applicable. For example, when we say she is a shining star, she is not literally a shining star, but because of her capabilities, her talent, she is called a shining star. It may provide clarity or identify hidden similarities between the two concepts, the two ideas. Another example is the typical teenage boy's room is a disaster area. The next one, hyperbole. Hyperbole is a Greek word which meaning axis in a figure of speech that uses extreme exaggeration to make a point or show emphasis. It is an exaggeration used for emphasis or humor. It emphasizes, evokes strong feelings, and creates strong impressions, like he is running faster than the wind. She cried so long that she made a lake. The next one, personification. Personification is a metaphor in which a thing or abstraction is represented as a person. The attribution of a personal nature or human characteristics to someone or something non-human, or the representation of an abstract quality in human form. For example, lightning danced across the sky. Rhea heard the last piece of pie calling her name. Lightning cannot dance actually, so we are giving lightning the qualities of a human. The same thing applies to the second example. The piece of pie cannot speak, but still we are personifying it with some human qualities by saying that piece of pie was calling her name. The next one, alliteration, and one of the most popular figure of speech used in poetry. Alliteration is a conspicuous repetition of identical initials, consonant sounds. Alliteration is a literary device where two or more words in a phrase or line of poetry share the same beginning consonant sound. The words may be adjacent or separated by one or more words, that is, they can be alternate words as well. Read down the example. The soul selects her own society, then shuts the door. S sound has been repeated here. The soul selects her own society. This has been taken from the poetry Soul Selects Her Own Identity, Own Society by Emily Dickinson. A classic example is She Sells Seashells by the Seashore. Another fan favorite is Peter Piper Picked a Peck of Pickled Peppers. Please keep trying these. These are tongue twisters as well. The next one, metonymy. Metonymy is a figure of speech in which a thing or concept is referred to by the name of something closely associated with that thing or concept. The whole house was busy in preparations. The whole house is a metonymy, as it stands for people who live here. Actually, it is not the house who is preparing, it is the people of the house who are preparing. The next, England decides to keep check on immigration. It's not actually England, it is the government of England, the people who are representing the government. So England is here referring to the government. The next one, symbolism. It is used most of the time in many motion movies. Symbolism is the use of symbols to signify ideas and qualities by giving them symbolic meanings that are different from their literal sense. Symbolism is the practice or art of using an object or a word to represent an abstract idea. An action, person, place, word, or object can all have a symbolic meaning. For example, to show the tick-tock of a watch while someone is waiting. Black is used to represent death or evil. White stands for life and purity. So here, tick-tock of watch, black and white, all these terms are part of symbolism. The next one is synecdoche. Synecdoche is a figure of speech in which a term for a part of something refers to the whole of something or vice versa. Synecdoche is different from metonymy. In synecdoche, the part that is used to represent the whole is actually a part of the whole. With metonymy, the thing that is used to represent the whole is not a part of the whole. For example, referring to a helper as a hand, beautiful are the feet that bring the good news. So hand has been a part of helper and feet are the part of the person who is bringing down the good news. So these synecdoche is actually a part of the person or the object that we are talking about, that we are referring to. The next one, imagery. It is visually descriptive or figurative language, especially in a literary work. Imagery means to use figurative language to represent objects, actions and ideas in such a way that it appeals to our physical senses. In simple terms, to give such a nice description to any of the object that the object appears in the mind of readers while reading a particular text. The night was black as ever, but bright stars lit up the sky. These lines are completely describing the type of night that was there. Color such as bright orange, dull yellow, rectangular, conical kind of shapes, sizes such as mini, tiny, small, medium, large, gigantic, huge, patterns such as waves, horizontal lines, or even checked patterns. These kind of things describe the things more beautifully and in an emphasized manner. One is euphemism. It is a mild or indirect word or expression substituted for one considered to be too harsh or blunt when referring to something unpleasant or embarrassing. For example, instead of died, we can say passed away. Instead of abortion, we can say pregnancy is terminated. And instead of saying the person is unemployed, we can say the person is between the jobs. The next one is eulogy. It is a speech or piece of writing that praises someone or something highly, especially a tribute to someone who has recently died. Eulogies may be given as a part of funeral services. Foreshadowing. Foreshadowing is an interesting concept that is used many a times in fictions and dramas as well. It is a literary device in which a writer gives an advance hint of what is to come later in the story. Sometimes a future event is mentioned earlier in the story, like a comment about a meeting between characters. An old man opens his drawers to find a magnifying glass and sees a revolver. This kind of thing can foreshadow the upcoming violence, the upcoming warning. The next thing is type of communication. I have specifically added the types of communication in this video because recently I have seen a paper in which there was a piece of communication and the questions were asked about what type of communication it is, horizontal or diagonal or downward or upward. So we will discuss the kind of communication so that we are able to answer those kind of questions. The first one is horizontal communication. It is the transmission of information between people, divisions, departments or units with the same level of organizational hierarchy. Okay, let's discuss another kind of communication. This is upward communication. It is the process of information flowing from the lower level of hierarchy to the upper levels. It is just like a normal person talking to a king or an employee talking to a boss. Downward communication is just contrary to upward communication. It is the flow of information and messages from a higher level inside an organization to a lower one. It can be like a king talking to his subjects, a boss talking to his employee. This one is diagonal communication. Cross-functional communication between employees at different level of organizational hierarchy is described as diagonal communication. The best example of this kind of communication would be a printing company. All functional divisions of a printing company, for example sales, production, upper hierarchy, must work very closely together to increase business, produce quality products and manage corporate holdings. Let us discuss now one important Latin term. This is prima facie. Prima facie is a Latin expression meaning on its first encounter or at its first sight. It is defined as something that has been proven or assumed to be true unless there is evidence presented to the contrary. For example, the 30 tons of drugs in his house that was discovered by police is prima facie evidence of his involvement in drug trafficking. Carpe diem is a Latin term. It is used to urge someone to make the most of the present time and give little thought to the future. Carpe diem, you only live once. Literature example includes Andrew Marvel's to his coy mistress and Robert Herrick's to the virgins to make much of time. The next term is vox populi. Vox populi is a Latin phrase that literally means voice of the people. It is used in English in the meaning the opinion of the majority of people. There is a very famous poem by John Dryden by the same name. Many people think that expression means that the people are always right, but it really implies that the will of the masses, right or wrong, is often irresistible. Another term, the last term for today, is illusion. It is an expression designed to call something to mind without mentioning it explicitly. An indirect or passing reference it can be. An allusion is when a person or author makes an indirect reference in speech, text or song to an event or figure. For example, don't act like a Romeo in front of her. This place is like a Garden of Eden. In simple terms, we can say allusion works as examples as well. There is a link given in the description of this video that contains the quiz of all these terminologies that we have covered. Please appear for the same and judge your knowledge. Here we go. Hope these terms, terminologies will be very useful for your any kind of literature related exams. Please subscribe to my channel to gain more knowledge about English literature and contact to join our face-to-face classes. Thanks a lot for watching.